Good day, everybody. I'm going to share with you our presentation about CA storage and equipment. This presentation gives you a view about the storage of fresh fruits. And the storage of fresh fruits, the basic of that is to control the atmosphere. And we're going to talk about it. And all ins and in and outs around this atmosphere we need to create to keep our fruits fresh. And also the fruits in China. So I'm Wim van den Berg, I'm owner of Van Amerongen, and I'm going to guide you through this presentation. You see the introduction, CA storage and equipment. Now, this is something about Van Amerongen. Van Amerongen is a company, is in, already in CA since 1969, let's say the 70s. We started to put our fruits in this region where we live into cooling and try to create the right atmosphere. We are selling our equipment, installing our equipment, guide our customers worldwide. Also in China already for quite a few years. Everything what we do is to develop and innovate. We need to make steps because the future, the nature, the fruits, it will all change. So one thing what we like to do is to work with knowledge centers, with the growers, with the farmers, to be more innovative than other companies, at least to be one step forward on what's going to happen. You see here, it's all about the fruits and all the logistics from the fruits. You see, it's from the orchard to the distribution and the shelf life. That means the shelf life is in the kitchen or on the table, ready to consume by our customers. And in that line, you have the harvest, transport, the cold store entering, CA storage, sorting, packing, a long way for all the fruits. And what we have to do, guide the fruits and take care that in every step in this chain, we take the maximum precautions to save our fruits. Because to save our fruits is not only in the CA storage, but also in the handling and in the orchard. How to treat the orchard, how do we feed our trees, how do we collect, how do we take the best fruits on the trees, take the worst parts out, so that we harvest only the best fruits. Take care for the transportation, because orchards sometimes are far away from the cooling or close by. As closer as possible, we like to have the facilities to bring your fruits. Cold store entry, quality controls, and then we have the storage. We want to keep them fresh for a longer period and for you before you're going to pack them and bring them to the market. We always say the top five most important questions before picking are: is the orchard really uniform? That means, do we have on all trees in that orchard the same size of fruit, the same shape, the same pressure, the same sugar content? That's what we want to achieve. We have to know more about the orchard. That means history. Does your orchard have already history? What is the behavior of the apples from the last couple of years? Behavior in the rooms, behavior in the supermarket. Can we keep them in a very good condition, these fruits? So history is important. That means history has to be written down. History has to be stored, because we learn from history. Picking at the right time. That means not too early, not too late. The right sugar content and the right pressure. Handling. Really important to train your people in the orchards. You have to train them how to pick the fruits, how to put them in the boxes. Handle with care, because the fruit is really strong when it comes from the tree. But even bruises, small bruises by fingers, you don't see them. But you see them later on in the chain. They will come up in a couple of months. So handle your fruits with care. So train your people how to pick and how to handle. And of course, transportation. transportation time as short as possible, as good as possible. And I know that we, especially in Holland, we live in a small country, in good roads, and the farthest we have to go with our fruits is maybe 1 or 1.5 hour. But most apples are stored within 20 minutes, 30 minutes from the orchard. But in countries like China, Mexico, countries, but huge countries, we need the apples or the fruits or the pears, they need to make a longer trip to the shea facility. Do that, handle it with care, take care for good roads and good infrastructure. Why shea storage? That we want to buffer. After harvesting, we need to buffer. We want to control the conditions to keep them in a good condition. Because we're making arrangements with your distributors. We make arrangements with supermarkets. We have to give warranty on our product. If we say this quality we deliver to you, you have to deliver quality. We want to limit the loss, because losses most of the time are drying out or bruises. We don't want to have that. So CA is a need for buffering over a longer period. So what is CA? CA is the most important part of CA is what we want to achieve is decreasing respiration rates. That means breathing. We all respirate. The humans are respirating, the animals are respirating, and also the fruits are respirating. So, and when you take it from the tree, we want to block respiration as soon as possible to keep them fresh without any losses, as just discussed. So lower the temperature is number one. Low temperature is blocking the respiration already for 70-80%. Look, make a comparison with your fridge. If you put fruit in your fridge or vegetables, you keep them longer fresh. Apply lowest oxygen concentration, because respirating is, what we do is breathing in, we need oxygen to live, also the fruits, and the more oxygen you will get, the higher the respiration rate. So if we bring the oxygen level down, you already block respiration. Temperature, low oxygen. And number three is the highest possible CO2 concentration. Also CO2 is blocking respiration. So it's a combination of temperature, number one, oxygen and carbon dioxide to keep the respiration as low as possible. And of course, certain varieties of fruits, we also check the ethylene, and we have to reduce moisture loss. I'll come back later to that subject. Here you see already on this slide, you see the green is the normal atmosphere. That means cooling. Both are cooling. Green and blue are cooling. Cooled areas. But we add, besides the cooling, the controlled atmosphere, low oxygen, higher CO2. And you see that pomegranates, for example, can be stored factor 3 longer. The garlic, even also factor 3. Cherries, factor 4. So you see that controlled atmosphere, when you use it in the right way, it will maintain the lifetime of the fresh fruits. And also some vegetables like Chinese cabbage. This slide will come back after every subject. It all happens here in the CA facility. And we measure and control the conditions. So we need CA equipment, we need the cooling. And of course, as I told you, history data is very important. So all the data we get from the fruits will be stored. And we can use the data to upgrade our protocols, to upgrade our knowledge of storage of your fruits. This is the equipment we produce to control the atmosphere. This is produced in the Netherlands, and this is what we export worldwide. That means the control system, the machinery, for lower oxygen, control of carbon dioxide, control of ethylene. And we all is connected to your computer or to your mobile phone. And you can see what's happening in all your rooms via the internet. This is a picture of a lineup of the equipments connected to the rooms and the CA facility. You see here the cooling, the control, and the CA equipment. One of the important parts is to control the CO2. Van Amerongen is building the carbon dioxide absorbers already for more than 50 years, and there is knowledge behind it. We want to take as much carbon dioxide out of the room via a machine, without spoiling energy, without heating up the air, without disturbing the oxygen level. So this is all in our carbon dioxide scrubber. It's very energy efficient, and we maintain the low oxygen in the rooms. And here we have our nitrogen machine that produces nitrogen. And you can see via our website how it functions, how it works. But what we do is we replace the higher oxygen with low oxygen, because we want to bring down the oxygen level around the 0.5 and 2%, depends which variety of fruits or vegetables are stored. So we need to make nitrogen, and we do that in a very efficient way with really low energy consumption to control your oxygen level. This is the PSA, is the high pressure one. We use that also to make nitrogen. And here we have the ethylene converter. The ethylene converter is burning the ethylene, especially on kiwis. For a lot of fruits, you don't need ethylene control, but for sure for the kiwi, you need a good ethylene control. Burn the ethylene, keep it as low as possible, and control it. Don't use only the machine, you also want to see what is my ethylene level in the room. Based on measurement, we can do an action to control this ethylene. Back to the same slide, we always come back. Facility, the control, the equipment you need, CA, and cooling. And of course, data, history. Of course, we have the cooling. The cooling is number one. So what we do with cooling, we just remove the warm, the heat from the room by using an evaporator in the room. And the cooler is taking the heat from the fruits and bring it out of your room, bring it outside of the building, and we use again all the freon, all the ammonia, all the glycol to cool your room. Cooling is number one. Control your cooling well. You see, we work with several systems. We can control them. We can control the cooler in the room. We can control the condenser and the compressors and the pressure, because it's a balancing. So you don't want to have a too cold room or too warm room. You don't want to put too much energy in your system. You want to control the running hours of the equipment, and you want to control the water loss. It's all to do with cooling. So our freon, our ammonia, our indirect glycol, it doesn't matter. It's all in our software. And it's just balancing and control. I'm not going in far details at the moment what our system can do, but I tell you what we do is control the atmosphere. Control the atmosphere, know what you're doing. So all the data from the fruits, all the data from the atmosphere, temperature at several places, oxygen, carbon dioxide, ethylene, you have to know what's going on. Otherwise, you really don't know what's happening with your fruits. Check. So, and I like the fruit cooler. They are specially designed for fruits. You can have all types of coolers, all types of compressor, but the cooler in your room is really balanced for fruits. So, investment in equipment, you really have to know what I'm going to invest in. And we have to find out the best coolers specific for your fruits, for your size of the room. Has to do with air circulation. Come back later to that. Now, to come back to sensoring, because measurement gives information and you need to measure in the right way. So you see here the CA room. You see here the cooler. You see here the boxes. This is a side view of the room. So this is the bottom. This is your concrete floor. Here we have a door. You don't see it, but it's there. And You see here the cooler. And it blows the air through your boxes to take the heat out from the fruits. So what are we going to measure? First of all, I like to measure in the cooler itself. What is my temperature in the cooler? Because of water, moisture loss of the fruits, you always lose a little bit of moisture. It can be built up in your cooler and it will freeze, and you can have a lot of ice in your cooler. So you have to defrost at the right time, especially in the start of the season. You need defrosting. Defrosting is measured by, ice is measured by one sensor in the block. The second sensor is, I want to measure the temperature of the air, what's coming out of the cooler. Because when it's too cold, it can freeze on the top. And when it's too warm, you don't have enough energy to cool your fruits. That's sensor number two. Sensor number three and four are in the boxes to measure my temperature in the boxes in the fruits. And of course, one temperature in the returning air, because the cold air is going this way and it will warm up because of taking off the heat. We measure here in the box and we measure here, and then we measure the returning air. And with these five sensors, I'm able to control the cooling system and I'm able to check if my fruits are still healthy. Uniformity of product temperature, that's important. Put the boxes in the right position with the right space to have the good air circulation. When I miss the top of the boxes, you have shortcut of air. If you put the apples on this side, you will have a shortcut of air. So bring the boxes in the right way in the room. You see here again what is good. And here you see what is wrong. When you miss the fruits, you have shortcut of air. When you put the boxes here, you have a shortcut of air. So stuck your apples, stuck the boxes in the right way. Here I want to show you again some photos that you see here. The boxes are, the room is, they're filling up the room slowly. You see the same type of boxes. They're really set up well with gaps between the boxes. And you see they are filled till the cooler. Here you see several types of boxes. So the airstream will be different. So it can be that some of the boxes won't have the right amount of air. So you don't cool that box as well. So really you need a good airflow. You need the right way of stacking. And you need the same type of bin per room. So what are we going to do? How we minimize water loss? Because water loss minimization, that's important. That means optimization of the cooling system, the right calculation, the right amount of kilowatts, and the right airflow. Of course, all controlled by the right software. So you see here, for example, these are pears. We grow them in Europe and also South Africa and Australia. They need a temperature below zero. So that means in the room it can be -1. So the air that's coming out is -8. So it can freeze the top. So we cover the top of the pears so they don't freeze. So all these things are found out and put in the software based on history. And of course you see here the water loss. So when you have ice on your cooler, we defrost the ice, we measure per room how much water is coming out, and that water loss is loss of moisture from your fruits. I go back, just jumping a little bit. So briefly, in one shot, you see here the cooling, the CA equipment, we control the temperature, the oxygen, the humidity from all the fruits, currants, kiwis, apples, cherries, blueberries, pears, etc. And we need to have the right CA room, gas tight, we need to control the moisture. So it has all to do with control, measurement and control, not by people, not by managers. It has to be the right equipment. The equipment that never sleeps and the equipment is very accurate. Of course, we need people who are checking. Who are checking the data, who are checking the machinery. But we need to have safe data storage and safe control. And that's what we do with our software for MyFruit. And that's what we do to show you what's going on. It looks very complicated. Of course, we have to train people. But this data can tell you exactly, are we storing our fruit well? And of course, we take samples out of the room. But I need this data. That makes your history, and that will tell you what is going on. Also, for soft fruits, we have solution. That means we have bags, special bags, where we can store berries, cherries, special fruits, what you only harvest in small amounts, bring to the market in small amounts. We have individual, small, flexible CA rooms. It's all connected, again, to a main control panel, so that we can keep our cherries, our berries, our red currants fresh for a longer period. Here we see a sort of what we saw in the picture, individual bags connected to the right control panel, carbon dioxide and low oxygen. That's what we have to control also. Here have still some pictures how we make these bags gas tight by welding it. We keep the fruits in there, and when you want to open it and you bring it to the market. It stays fresh. And when you have soft fruits in bigger amounts, we also have very small, special CA rooms where we can put small amounts of fruits in. It's more or less a big flexible part, and from the flexible part we go again to the CA rooms, small rooms to store very high valuable soft fruits. And important is in the whole story what I just told you, save the data, because data gives you new view. It makes you can produce new protocols for storage. So what we do, we save data. Your computer is connected to your database, and take care that this data is protected. For a lot of customers, we protect the data. They have a contract with us, and we can save the data. So if something happens, at least we can push the data back. So data can't be lost. We're talking about gas tightness. Gas tightness. We started in the 70s to the 90s, 2000, 2020. We're making steps because of the change of the atmosphere in the world, changing of the fruits, changing of the storage period. We need to upgrade. We need to upgrade the quality of the building. We need to upgrade the quality of the concrete floor, to upgrade the way we construct the CA rooms. We have to make it gas tight because we expect better quality of fruits. We have more and more also high value sensitive fruits, and we want to protect them. So take care that your investment will be done in the right way. And we have to design it. Designing and specifications. Specification of the panels, specification of the concrete, specification of the cooling system. We have to bring them all together. Because when you start your construction, you need to know exactly what you're going to get, and you want to have the right quotation of the right companies. So we start always with a design. Design and make your specs. That's what we do. That's where we have a lot of customers. We make 3D designs. Side view is all AutoCAD, so we can send them to everybody. They can use it to make the quotations, so that nobody can make a story. Everybody has the same drawing, the same specifications, so, and the basic of this is important for your investment. And assembling, number two, after you buy, when you want to deal with companies, you have to be sure that they are able to do the job. So you need references. So you need the right equipment to fit things together. You need the right people who know what assembling from panels is. So we need to take care for details. We need to work with the right companies. So, Simon, we need to protect our panels. Now you can put the boxes in the room, but if you put the box to the panel can be damaged, guest tightness is gone. So all these details, how to set up the room, what to put in the rooms, we've done it. We have 50 years of work in CA, so much experience, and we want to share that experience. We want to share it with you because you are the investor. You have to use the equipment and you want to protect our fruits. You see here, the cooler, I told you, the most important part, as wide as possible. That end of the room to this end of the room. I need an airflow. Good airflow to take the heat away from your fruits. So we need to make it gas tight. We need special coating, special connection to the floor because we have to lower oxygen, 1% or lower. So all the holes, we have to make it tight, very, very gas tight. This is a beautiful picture, it's years old already. This is the other CA rooms here. This is a block and here we have a block. This is a floor where you can walk. You can see all the equipment from the cooling, the CA, water loss, flexible part of the rooms. Even the roof is isolated. We even cool this area because when it's outside 30 degrees, 35, we still maintain it here on 10 or 15 degrees just to keep it clean and dry and that the heat won't go into the room. So this is how we construct CA facilities and cold rooms. And this is the same corridor, but now on the floor. Here you have the individual rooms. Make it clean, make it simple, use the right materials. No condensation, no cold bridges in the construction. Very important. Nice view of the same construction, 3D drawings. And again, back, storage, equipment, control. Why gas tight? And what are we going to do for the future? We worked on a new model, on a new way of controlling the atmosphere. We are taking the information from the fruits. We measure breathing of the fruits now. And based on breathing of the fruits, we can lower the oxygen. We can create the atmosphere the fruit wants to have. Here you see why. Because this expensive fruit from Australia, South Africa, they have problems with oxidation. That has all to do that they could not use any chemicals anymore for the export. So chemicals were gone, oxidation came. And now, of our dynamic system, we're measuring the lowest possible oxygen. We control that by measuring the breathing, we can prevent oxidation, we can prevent scalds. We work on this system for the last 8 years and we installed it 4 years ago already in South Africa, Australia, and now we install it worldwide. That means we talk with the fruit, we communicate with the fruit, and we call that dynamic CA. So we fight scalds and we save energy because the lower the respiration, less cooling is needed, you save energy and you save moisture loss. You see the RQ, respiration coefficient. You see, that's the green line. You see the oxygen level here. Yeah, we even store at 0.3. In most rooms in the world, we store between 1 and 2%. But this is the interesting part for the future. Really impressive, especially for sensitive fruits. So we want to control the oxygen between 0.2 and 0.5, this is the important range. And you see, we measure the respiration of the fruits And when the respiration stays low, we can keep the oxygen low. And when the ethanol development is going up, we raise the oxygen. So that means we go as low as possible, but we want to prevent alcohol in the fruits, because it can kill the fruits. So measurement and control and communicate with the fruits, that's important. We can see here, the green line is the oxygen uptake. When the fruit is breathing, when your oxygen level is above 3%, the fruit is breathing like in the fridge. So you have to bring down your oxygen level. When you bring down your oxygen level, the CO2 level production is also going down. You block respiration. This is between 0 and 1%. This is really important. But we don't want to see this line going up, because this is fermentation. So we have to find the optimum point. An optimum point will be sent to us via communication with the fruit, by measuring the breathing of the fruit. So respiration is the produced CO2 divided by the oxygen uptake. And that's what we do. We measure how many CO2 production do we have and how many oxygen taking up. And when that stays between 1 and 1.5, the fruit is healthy. So we prevent, the RQ is going up here, and this is the lowest point of oxygen. So we measure this, and at the moment the RQ is going up, that you produce more CO2 than the oxygen uptake. At this point, this is the lowest point of storage. This is what the fruit is telling us. Dynamic. That will come to China, definitely. And it's also showed in your software, on your computer, on your mobile, it is show if this dynamic part is controlled well. When everything is green, it is good. And when it is red, we have to do something. The software will add some oxygen. So please, you can relax. But you want to see it. You want to see the nice green part. And if it is red, the software will say, I give some oxygen to that room. So don't be afraid. We are on the edge, but we can control it. Because you want to sell your fruits for the best price and optimal condition. And with all this information we got from history, we're making the protocols. The protocols for every type of fruit. And this protocol we put in our software. So if you have a Fuji either by Pink Lady or Akers Pink, this is the way, this is the model, this is the protocol that we use to store them. We fill the room, we cool down the room, and then we bring the oxygen down. Then we are already in day 9. From day 9 on, slowly the room come in a normal CA condition. And in 2.5 weeks, then we are in real CA. Low oxygen, low controlled CO2, and a good temperature. And after 4 weeks for these fruits, we start dynamic storage. That means we start to communicate with the fruits to bring the oxygen down from the 1.5, bring it down to what the fruits allows to have. Communication. So we have this for many types of fruits, many types of pears, soft fruits. So we put this in the software and it will automatically do the job. Sorry. Of course, we have some new products. We are also in ripening. Ripening of fruits, ripening of avocados, bananas, mangoes. We have the equipment to do that. We have the laboratory systems. So we all test on small scale. This is in Turkey. This is in New Zealand. So we help the local to check the local production with very simple, very basic, simple systems to find out what is safe. What can we do to upgrade the shelf life of the product? So this is figs and these are kiwis, for example. And here we have a few. I go back. Something is. Sorry. Here you see that we deliver in all countries, not only in China and in Holland, also in Australia, UK, everywhere in the world, Russia. You see, this photograph can be made at any location in the world, as long as we also can be involved in the together with the right companies in the layout of the building. What kind of cooling do we have? What do we have to control? And these are our partners worldwide. We have partners Russian-speaking, Chinese-speaking, Spanish-speaking, and I speak only Dutch and English, so forgive me. We work with in all types of climates, all types of fruits. We have experience, and we like to share that with you. Our first dynamic storage in Novo, South Africa. Cooling control, CA control. And if you want to talk with them, they're open. You can ask questions. Our neighbor here, not far from this place. You see the pictures, the corridors, panels, control, dry, clean, keep it dry, keep it controlled. And in this way, with this short presentation, I hope you understand that our roots is in CA, is in storage, is in protecting our fruits, protecting our vegetables. That's what we do. And not only with the machines, but also with our know-how. Also to work with worldwide knowledge centers. Wageningen University, ETA in Spain, Leuven in Belgium, South Africa, near Kaapstad, Stellenbosch. We work with researchers because they help us. Because there's one goal for all of us. We want to have the best stored products. So that you, when you open the room, bring it to the market, that the people are happy and buy it again. We want to keep it fresh and we want to save waste. And I hope that you understand the presentation. And of course, if you have any questions, please let us know. We are there. And I hope to meet you soon in China. And I wish you a very pleasant day. And for sure, thank you very much.